I've always been the sensitive type, and you know that can be painful. I never made my move until the time was right, and you know the waiting was awful. I've always tried to do what I should. Though I love you too much for my own good. Well, it hasn't been that long that I've known you, and I think it's already too late. If I told you I love you, what would you do? Would your reaction be that? So I must love you too much for my own good. Well, I've had a lot of love's experience. Some were good and some so bad. And I think that it's starting to make me tense. You know, a fear of love is so sad. Is getting ready to live, then growing old must be getting ready to die. Then your journey in that way, 'cause you might ne'er do tomorrow what you don't do today. There are no second chances, and life is cruel that way. nobody, no one. So use what you have to get what you need. Do what you know is right and say what you need. Cause God is waiting at the end of the road, and all the steps are to God. And there won't be any lying to that which already knows. That if getting ready to live is growing up,
center, the more alone, the more further apart we all are, like the stars, as we expand through time. We all become dispersed from the center, and the center, as it goes outward, it thins out into the nothing. You must understand that in any eternity, any reality must mechanically, it must exist within a bubble projected from its center. You must understand that infinity is the greater, and it has no limits, it's eternal. The only limits are what it allows inside of itself. And those are dangerous. What would happen then? And once God got it rolling, could God stop it? I'm sure God can. I'm sure that we can if we want to. You know, we're all part of it. We're all part of God. Here, in our little bubble. Seems like a big bubble. You look out there and you think it goes forever. And it does, but not on this side of it, the mirror. We're the illusion, you understand? We're the part of the mirror that's looking back and doing what we're reflected to do. Gravity is the single primary force, and it goes to the center, and thank God for that one thread that we have that connects us to the God, the center. You see, in an eternity, any entity let's just let it go. You gotta understand, this is all there is. Here and now, you and me, and all of us. All the that we love and all the people that we hate and all the people that we just don't care about at all. That's sort of the problem, you see. If we understood that we are all the same entity, if we all understood that there is only one God in the center, and gravity and time are the result of each other in an endless loop, as we travel through time and gravity.
But oh, what can he do? They took his will to live, and they took his leg too. And what will we do when Johnny comes home again? Psychotropics and antidepressants too. And what will we do when Johnny's home again? Supposed to do. And what will we do now that Johnny's home again? Now that Johnny's home again, hurrah, now that Johnny's home again. His friends or family recognize, and there he dies, and Johnny's gone home again.
To the truth that could lead us to the truth, to lead us to the path of everlasting life. You see, if you all go on searching for the stars, and that's okay, but you've got to understand the reality of what that is. The stars are a much lonelier place than dead. There's no life. The life is here with us, with the water and the gravity. It's obvious that this whole sphere of existence is set up around us. We all know it to be true. There is no other explanation except it is meant for us, and we are meant for it. in the wrong direction. Looking outward in time. Away from what gives us all that we have. The center is where our God is at. The center is where our life is at. The center is what holds the kingdom of heaven together. Don't you see? Don't burn it up. Don't blow it up. Don't murder it. Don't rejoice in its death. None of it. Don't kill any of it. Stop burning any of it. You heard a bug. Would you like to be smashed? It's okay. I mean, it's with that. But I mean, it's all about the intent and what you're trying to do. You're trying to hurt things, trying to kill things. I understand. You want to win. I want to win. Everybody wants to win. We don't have to kill each other. We don't have to have our kids kill each other. We don't have to. I insist. We don't have to. To do so is a rebellion against life itself. God tells me that that's how it was before the last cataclysm, great cataclysm. They rebelled against life itself when they found out how it was, when they realized there was nowhere else to go forever. It drove them mad. They started sacrificing their own babies to live forever. Their fear of death made them homicide, suicidal, reject life altogether, trying to hold on to it. Of course, they had a lot longer to think about it. They used to live a lot longer than we do now. The way we kill ourselves off, it makes you wonder how long we could live if we didn't have a machine in place that kills everyone. Hear that trash truck out there? That's a lot like our society. And our people turn into trash.
Thank you.
the people what they want.
Welcome, my friends, to our establishment. I hope you brought your initial investments. Now just sign on the bottom line, and everything will be just fine. And let's make one thing clear, if you want more than you'll pay here.
Thank you.
going on right now. Purge. Mass death of others so that we might live. I'm not going with y'all. I'm going to stay with God here. I'm unhappy with God. It's mighty lonely sometimes. I'll tell you the truth. I miss y'all. I miss you. But you're all just a dream there or other. With God, there's the possibility of other dreams. If you go away from God, then you just fade into the nothing. And you're gone. But if you know, and if you stick with God, you can stay. Try it again. If there's a place to come back to again, you understand? If you burn it up and kill it all, there's no other place to go. No other heaven. No other planet. No other reality that need concern you at any rate. This is all there is for you and me and all of us. It's here and now. Choose the path of destruction or choose the path of eternal life. Both are eternal. You need to understand what eternal is. Eternal is probably not what you think it is. It's not male, it's not female. It's not hot or cold. It's not light or dark. There's no time, no gravity. There's nothing but God, and nothing else but this, and here, in time, and now, in gravity. I don't know why I'm telling you all this. Chances are, just make it worse. Tesla told you about a death ray, and look what you've done with it. You built it, exactly. You're not meant to realize. You know, the signature of the Creator and all that. I have to believe. It feels like God's told me that. That I'm not giving enough credit to the Creator for how things are. I blame it on us. It's got to be us. It can't be. We are God, you understand this. We're all part of this. We're all rolling around in it. Spinning around in gravity. Little DNA strands.
Endless dream.
city lights grow dim. Wind blows, sun shines, these things test our minds. Thank you. the impossible dream.
When the gravity stops, time stops. We all disperse. Neighborhoods, nests, not even nothing eyes. Come to nothing. Oh, did nothing. That's the thing, see. We always count in ones, you understand? But nobody defined what one is. And that's the thing. Everything outward from one is a fantasy. One is eternity. One is infinity. One and nothing else. They're the only two things that exist at the same time in space. Everything and nothing. If there's a mirror, there's a reflection. You and me and the devil makes three. When three comes into play, that's when the gamesmanship starts. You understand? And all the magic that we've created here. If you can remember, if you can follow that thread that you have back to the creator, creation, at the bottom of gravity, and you go all the way back, and remember the nothing, the mirror, the reflection, and then three. What if there were two of us? And then, what if there were three? Could any two be the single one? It's a fun game. But it was only reflections. Remember. Go all the way back. Remember. Beloved. Decision here at the end of time, but not necessarily could be the beginning of a new time. If you understand how it is and quit your fantasies, you're dreaming in the stars, looking at the sky. Oh, that sun, that moon, those planets and their moons, and all those stars. Oh, so wonderful. Think of the possibilities. Aye. But primarily concern yourself with the possibilities here and now. where it matters. Wake up! Thank you for listening.
So we say.